Welcome to Full Chat, where you get the fast facts and the facts fast.
Full Chat is brought to you by AAA Travel. Easy on the wallet and easy to plan. AAA travels with you.
We're back again, debating drags or checkered flags, with Dr. Horace Power from the Nitro Policy Institute and Frank Discussion, chairman of the U.S. Speed Council.
Thanks for having me. It's good to be here.
Gentlemen, we're quickly approaching the election that will set the tone for the next 4 years of motorsports. Checkered flags and driver Joey Logano are primed to make a serious run at the incumbent drags and driver Robert Hight. What will make 2020 different? Frank, let's start with you.
Well, the difference is distance, Sue. Drag racing had its moment in the sun, but a 1,000-foot straightaway just isn't going to cut it anymore. Americans today have an appetite to see racing in all its complexity and nuance, which means 500 laps of drama, strategy, and high-octane intrigue.
Oh, sorry. Did you say 500 laps? People like to take road trips, not watch them. Nothing ignites the soul like the power and the glory of 10,000 horses rocketing down a track.
So then, is this an issue of quality versus quantity?
No, not at all, Sue. I'd say stock car racing has the best of both worlds. More miles, more competitors, more variables. And that's why I feel extremely positive about Checkered Flags' chances in 2020. As long as there isn't any funny business from those funny cars.
There they go again with the same old unfounded accusations. Drags was cleared of any wrongdoing by the Muffler Report. The witch hunt is over. But I guess these same old arguments are what you'd expect from people who like to drive in circles.
Well, that's all the time we have. Will it be checkered flags over drags, or drags over checkered flags? Only time will tell. After the break, how loud is too loud? The answer may surprise you.